Warning, Curse of Strahd, spoilers ahead. We rejoin Barakas the Rogue, Nala the Druid, Xaeli the Ranger, Torrin the Paladin, Zandala, Boblia, and Irina Kolyana as they head west towards the Tser Pool Encampment and the mysterious Madam Eva. Madam Eva is rumored to be a seer who might be able to tell the party more about the vampire and possibly grant them valuable insights into the land of Barovia as a whole. The party currently has a few options. They can drop Irina off at a safe place like Valaki or Kresg, they can go visit Madam Eva, or they can hunt down the child cooking grandma. Before we continue, please make sure you've subscribed to my channel. It helps me out a lot. While there are civilized areas of Barovia, the nation's land is largely untamed wilderness, broken by few roads. There is nothing to suggest what is causing Hissy the owlbear to appear as a skeleton. Alas, it has nothing to do with Torrin and is completely outside of his control. You see, domains like Barovia are special demiplanes under full control of the one who rules. Depending on the ruler, spells are often altered to have distinct aesthetic differences, though it is rumored some spells can be changed entirely. The party is on the road for a little over an hour before a wolf the size of a grizzly bear steps out of the swirling fog. Behind the massive wolf is a sizable pack of similarly large wolves. These wolves appear hungry, eyeing the party with malicious delight before charging. Nala wastes no time throwing a maelstrom onto the wolf pack, pulling them into a tight cluster and bashing their bodies together. A pair of fireballs and lightning arrows later, the air is filled with the smell of burned fur. The party daintily picks their way past the corpses. It's nice that the unbreakable arrows are performing well.
No need to be smug.
I'm not! I just wasn't sure they were going to work.
Barakas wonders if breaking Barakas's arrows would make them more dangerous. Barakas is unsure.
Wouldn't they be too short to fire from your bow?
Nala is right. Barakas will continue to infect Barakas's arrows then. Good afternoon!
The f*** is this?
While the party was talking, a wild Vasili von Holtz appeared. He has changed garments since the party last saw him, but he's near a pair of fishing rods and a box of tackle.
How was your time in the village of Barovia?
Lovely place. One of a kind. Very unique.
Filled with child killers.
Child killers? What do you mean?
What do you mean, what do we mean? You're supposed to know everything about Barovia.
If I ask you a question, it generally means I am unsure of the answer. Now what do you mean? Child killers. Children are our future, I would have you know.
Is it the 80s?
You've got little old ladies making children into meat pies and vanishing into nothingness when confronted. You've got a problem.
What? Morgantha? No, she doesn't turn them into pies.
She said fatten them up. So unless she has too many children she's feeding because she's a kind old lady.
Yeah, she definitely puts them in cages, so it looks bad.
We live in such dark times. Are any of you good at fishing? Do you want to challenge me to a fishing duel, so to speak?
No thanks.
I have zero interest in fishing.
Also, for being a noble, you really don't dress like one.
I don't know. It's sometimes fun to dress below one's station. It allows you to move less conspicuously.
I don't understand this.
Don't you have a job or something?
I am Vasili von Holtz. I have no job other than to be a noble.
Cool.
That much is clear. Do you have to be a noble out in the wilderness?
The towns are so dreary. I need to be in the wild to escape the everyday drudgery for a little while. Surely you understand.
As we were saying, child killers.
Yes, that drudgery.
I suppose you have a point. But still, no one wishes to fish. I'll even go easy on you.
Have you even fished in your life?
Does he have anything else to do?
So he's fishing all the time.
Is there a reason you haven't left Barovia entirely?
What do you mean, leave entirely?
You seem to have very little interest in the towns as they are. You don't want to do anything about this mist that's keeping you in this self-proclaimed dreary location?
I couldn't leave even if I wanted to, so I make the most of what I have.
Even with the vampire terrorizing people?
It's not that bad. You just have to avoid the wolves, the eddercaps, the spiders, the bats, the druids, the berserkers, and the evil gypsies. You'll be fine.
What was that about druids?
Oh, the evil druids of Yesterhill? You've never heard of them.
Nope. Do tell.
Yes, the druids at Yesterhill. They perform odd rituals and worship the vampire. They like to pretend they have some impact on the fate of Barovia.
Seems like this guy is popular.
Alright, here. I'll fish and then let's get moving.
Nala picks up a fishing pole and the race is on! This fishing competition is different from a regular snooze fest because successful nature checks allow a competitor to land a fish immediately. Being a druid, Nala immediately lands the first fish. Vasili also catches a fish. Score 1-1.
Again.
Both lines enter the water at rapid pace. The race is on! Vasili lands another fish while Nala wrestles another one out of the water. Score 2-2.
Again. A winner must be decided.
Nala has the cast of her life and manages to catch two fish with the same hook. Vasili, distracted by the superb fish woman,
catches nothing.
Rats!
Not sure what this proves, but yeah!
You have one. Do you mind if I keep these fish?
Go for it.
What do you need the f***ing fish for? You're rich as sh-.
I was planning to eat them. I dislike wasting food.
Vasili walks over to Nala and hands her a bulging pouch.
For your win.
Thank you. Good battle?
With that, Vasili gathers up the fish and disappears into the mist.
What's in the pouch, Nala?
Nala opens the pouch and receives 100 gold.
All right. 100 gold divided by how many?
You're not obligated to share. You want it with your own skill.
Yeah, you're not.
Bedicus is poor.
The party continues on, though they get a sense that they're being watched. Not quite concealed by the twilight, mist, and trees, the party glimpses some primitively garbed individuals standing and staring. Xaeli waves at them, which causes them to hoogla-roogla the heck out of there.
Well, that works.
In the evening, the party comes to a fork in the road. An old wooden gallows creaks in a chill wind that blows down from the high ground to the west. A frayed length of rope hangs from its beam. The well-worn road has a sign at the split, pointing off in three directions. Barovia Village to the east, Tser Pool to the northwest, and Ravenloft Valaki to the southwest.
Irina, do you want to go to the town first, or do you want to go to that encampment? We should go to the Tser Pool Encampment. I swear Madam Eva will lead you right. She's been nothing but kind to me since I was a girl. Yes, but do you want to go with us, or do you want us to see you to a town first? Whatever your fate is, I feel like I have a right to know. Goodness knows you already know mine should I not evade the vampire. Up to you. You're welcome to come along.
And let's go.
Another few hours of travel pass by when suddenly the party reaches a large encampment by the water. Many colorful tents are pitched outside a ring of wagons. A much larger tent stands near the lake, clearly lit from within. Near this tent, 8 horses stand near the water. A mournful tune can be heard clashing with the singing of several figures cavorting near a bonfire.
Irina, would you care to lead on?
Didn't Vasili say something about evil gypsies?
He did. And these look like strange people. Are they gypsies? What is a gypsy?
I don't know.
Irina, are these the people you were looking for? Or the people you told us to look for? Yes, though I don't see Madam Eva. I hope she is nearby. Perhaps we should introduce ourselves. What does she look like? She's fairly old and a woman. She's hard to miss, if you say so.
The party wanders into the encampment and are greeted by one of the residents.
Oh, dragon thing! What are you doing here? What are you?
I'm called a dragonborn. Is this not a common species in this area?
No, not at all! There are only humans here, and some undead.
Only humans? No elves?
If you count the dusk elves outside Valaki, maybe. But they're gonna die out soon enough.
Depressing for them.
They got no women left. No chance at reproduction.
Equally depressing. Why are there no women left?
Who sexed the elves?
Oh, Strahd killed him.
Why?
Because they rose up against him, of course. Nothing good happens to you when you contest Strahd's rule.
So the Dusk Elves as a people were killed, or just the womenfolk?
He killed the women to punish the whole race. Not that there was much left of them.
Joy. So he's that kind of asshole.
That's not very nice. Strahd's not so bad.
He killed an entire race of women.
And how many people have you killed, dragon thing born?
More than plenty, but I don't commit genocide. At least not intentionally.
What's genocide?
You know they can't reproduce, but you don't know about genocide?
It's a limited biology class.
Right?
I don't know Genesis, Genesing, Genahoo.
You just said they were dying out.
Yeah, only the men are left. No more Dusk Elf women.
He specifically targeted killings to end the race. That's genocide.
He's Strahd the Conqueror. He'll do what he wants. These are his lands.
If you say so. Is Madam Eva here? I was told to ask for her.
Oh, yeah. You want to see her? She's in that big tent over there. Come back if you want to hear a story. I got a good one.
About what?
About the last person who showed up here. Man, he was something.
Who was that?
A mighty wizard came to this land over a year ago. I remember him like it was yesterday. He stood exactly where you're standing. A very charismatic man he was. He thought he could rally the people of Barovia against the devil Strahd. He stirred them with thoughts of revolt and spurred them to the castle en masse. When the vampire appeared, the will of his peasant army broke and they fled in terror. Few stood their ground and were never seen again. The wizard and the vampire cast spells at each other. Their battle flew from the courtyards of Ravenloft to the precipice overlooking the falls. Thunder shook the mountainside and great rocks tumbled down upon the wizard. Yet by his magic, he survived. Lightning from the heavens struck the wizard. And again, he stood his ground. But when the devil Strahd fell upon him, the wizard's magic could not save him. I saw him thrown 1,000 feet to his death. I climbed down to the river to search for the wizard's body to see if, you know, he had anything of value. But the river had already spirited him away.
How long have you been waiting to tell that story?
Years! Never mind, it happened last year. No one has wanted to hear the story because everyone has already seen it. But you're new!
Well, you have fun telling the next person who comes along.
Nala walks over to the large tent and announces,
"Excuse me. Madam Eva."
Come in, come in!
No, I don't want to.
Magic flames cast a reddish glow over the interior of Madam Eva's tent, illuminating a low table covered in a velvet cloth. Flits of light appear in the crystal ball. Behind it stands the figure of an impossibly old woman.
At last you have arrived! Are you ready for your fortunes, my dears?
If it's anything like the deck of many things, I'll pass.
What is the deck of many things, dear?
It's a deck with many things in it.
How remarkably non-specific!
Irina, help. You should probably have her tell you your future. Fine.
Madam Eva takes out a deck of cards and begins placing them on the table. Three cards go horizontally in a line. One is placed above, and one is placed below. The values of these cards are incredibly important to the rest of the adventure, as they give hints where valuable information and ancient artifacts are hidden. If the party chooses to do their due diligence, they will have a significant advantage when they take the fight to Strahd von Zarovich. The cards can be pre-selected if your dungeon master wants, but these cards were randomly chosen.
You want to defeat Strahd, do you?
We haven't talked about it yet.
Well, if you don't, there's no way out, my dear.
Okay, cool. Let's go kill Strahd.
Then let us begin. The first vision is that of a charlatan, a lonely mill on a precipice. The treasure lies within.
Do we all have the same prophecy?
Indeed. A druid, an evil tree, grows atop a hill of graves where the ancient dead sleep. The ravens can help you find it. Look for the treasure there. An anarchist, walls of bones, a chandelier of bones, a table made of bones, all that remains of enemies long forgotten.
Does the order of the cards matter?
Order is chaos. How you choose to use your fortune is entirely up to you. The enemy of the vampire, a drunkard man, trapped by the mists. He drinks his life away. He will be an unfaltering ally in these dark lands. You will find him at the source of his stupor. And last, where you will find the vampire himself, the executioner. I see a figure on a balcony, looking down upon this tortured land with a twisted smile.
Madam Eva slowly gathers her cards before stopping as the threads of reality suddenly warp inside the tent. Madam Eva looks at the group strangely, as if seeing everyone for the first time. Irina suddenly receives Madam Eva's full attention.
My dear Tatiana, he has found you again, it seems.
My name is Irina. Why do you call me Tatiana?
Nothing at all. Though I see that since you have left the village of Barovia and the marks on your neck, Strahd is ready to try to turn you to his bride again.
Were you his bride before?
What do you mean, again? No, I was never Strahd's bride.
Oh, but you have always been close. If you are not careful, you will be taken again.
Joy, I'm just liking this guy more and more every minute. My love, is she Tatiana or Irina? I'm confused.
I think she's both.
What do you mean she's both?
Well, she thinks she's Irina, which means she's Irina. But we know from Donovich that Kolyan Indirovich is not her father. There's a lot about her past we don't know. I mean, it might be a trick or a play on words, but if Madam Eva says she was once Strahd's bride, then she probably was.
Wait, so you mean Irina was lying to us?
No, I don't think she remembers. It doesn't seem like she's lying. If she was lying, it would be a terrible idea to bring us to Madam Eva, you know?
Do we have Torrin's Zone of Truth her? I'm feeling a little suspicious.
Torrin!
What's up? Xaeli updates Torrin on Xandala's suspicions. Do you want me to do it here, or do you want to wait until we're in the wilderness and can sit in a circle around her and demand the truth?
The second one.
We'll feel Barakas and Nala in later then. But what the f is going on here? Nothing good is going to come of this.
No, probably not.
My dear adventurers, is there anything else Madam Eva can help you with?
Do we want to stay the night here since they have an already set up area? It's either that or go across the road into the other woods, which seems silly.
Let's ask, but we might as well stay. We can post a watch, but I'd be more comfortable here than in the wilderness.
Worst case, if we have to fight, we can pick up a horse and throw it at them. Wait, pick up the people and throw them. The horse didn't do anything wrong.
Hi! My name's Galiro.
Throw Galiro at them.
With Madam Eva's blessing, the party stays the night in the Tser Pool Encampment. Torrin, Xaeli, and Xandala join the gypsies, known as the Vistani, by the fire and merrily drink. Barakas and Nala chill while Irina is quiet, clearly caught deeply in her own thoughts. The night passes relatively uneventfully and the party rests. Who is Madam Eva? Surprisingly, she's exactly who she presents herself as, a mysterious woman with the power of prophecy. But is she aligned with Strahd von Zarovich, or is she his enemy?
Neither. Madam Eva is an ageless Vistani and has been alive in Barovia since its creation and its condemnation to skulk in the mists for all eternity. Like all Vistani, Madam Eva can leave Barovia whenever she pleases, but she stays for several reasons. One is to give Strahd's playthings a fighting chance, but she is also a respected leader of the community. Speaking of...
You are mine, Irina. May your newfound friends protect you with their lives, however short they may be.
Daughters! We may have visitors in the next few days! Under what suspicions? I was accosted in the streets of Barovia. A small group of do-good ruffians has taken a stance against our pies. How distasteful! Let the Night Mother deal with them. The Night Mother has been silent for many years, Bella. We must look after ourselves. Did you bring any sickly children, Mother? I could use their teeth to tend the shrine. You are not listening! I was accosted in the streets! No children! Should we kill them? No. I saw Ismark the Lesser take custody of the children and can reclaim them at my leisure. He will not willingly surrender them, Mother. I hope he doesn't!
A quick thank you to my patrons. And thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share this video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and consider becoming one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you all next time.